On Friday, the 5th Congressional District Debate took place at the Frank Batten School of Leadership and Public Policy. WVA News attended the event to find out more.
Democratic candidate Leslie Coburn and Republican candidate Denver Riggleman debated a variety of topics, ranging from national issues, foreign policy, and local concerns, including taking questions from members all over the community.
I live in Rappahannock County. My husband and I have had our farm there for nearly 20 years. Before that, I was an investigative journalist for 35 years. I've written books, magazine pieces, covered some of the most important issues of our time.
The fact that I'm actually sitting in my alma mater talking to you at the Batten School, running for Congress, makes me part of the American dream. And it's something that I'm so very proud to be a part of. I'm running because I had lobbyists and cronies try to control what we were doing in the 5th District when we built our distillery, Silverback Distillery, in Afton, Virginia. And as we go through this debate, you're going to hear why I'm running, why this is personal.
The first question centered around health care, in which the two candidates had differing viewpoints.
I find it completely amazing that we think the government can control every function of our lives. So for me, I want health savings accounts. I want portability of health care. I think we can keep some of the good things of Obamacare. What I don't want is to have the government controlling every aspect of our Medicare.
In a rebuttal, Ms. Coburn called out Mr. Riggleman for being a member of the Freedom Caucus, which believes guaranteed care for those with pre-existing conditions is unconstitutional. Coburn supports restoring and improving the Affordable Care Act. Another highlight of the night was when both candidates discussed the accessibility and affordability of college.
Interest rates can change. Any student should be able to change their interest rate according and get the lowest rate that anyone who's getting a loan today gets. Also, for those people willing to work in counties that are underserved, if you're a teacher, if you're a doctor, if you're a nurse, anything useful for those counties, I would just get rid of your student loan.
In a rebuttal to her point, Mr. Riggleman argued that student loans are a problem, but giving out free money isn't the best solution. Instead, Riggleman suggests a Perkins loan, so there is a shared risk between the university and the government to avoid a financial crash. While most of the debate included a non-confrontational exchange of ideas, some parts got a bit more heated, especially when concerning the Equal Rights Amendment.
This is one of the most important things to me. I'm the granddaughter of a suffragette and have spent my entire adult life pushing for equal rights for women in the workplace.
But as far as Equal Rights Amendment, I'm just going to say this. I think the Constitution covers what we need to do. I don't think we need another amendment. Thank you.
Medicaid.
Medicare for all, which is a great idea.
Medicare for all is a utopian pie in the sky idea. I think that's just an idea that just isn't going to work. So I think what we need to do is we have to look at some other options that probably are a little bit more common sense than Medicare for all, and it's something I want to support. Thank you.
And corporate interests.
You're taking money from the Koch brothers. Does that matter? And also some corporate money. Does that have an effect? I would say yes.
The night ended with both candidates encouraging citizens to vote on November 6th.
From WUVA News, this has been Nicole Wooten.